Hey friends, and welcome back to Amanda Muse. We are kicking it old school with a little bit of a makeup show and tell. What I've been using on my face lately for the very glowy look, basically this look right here, which I tend to do like real quick in the morning when I'm not doing a full face of makeup. I'm just using my fingers mostly to apply this makeup. I will get into that in a moment. And of course, just to keep it kind of fun, I thought I could do a Q&A while I share my makeup with you and get ready. So it's gonna be a little bit of a, hopefully not the longest video of life, but it's gonna be fun, so let's do this. Now, if you're new, I would love it if you would consider subscribing. I put out videos 3 times a week, Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, and we always have a good time, so hit that little button. Okay, before I jump to my first question, the first product I'm going to show you is my moisturizer. This is the Clinique Dramatically Different Moisturizing Gel. I've used this product for ages, but then ran out and have tried other products in between. And I just like a very nice and light moisturizer to apply during the day. I just really like this lotion, so that's what I use as my base. The first question comes from Instagram, and this is at Hulig Elena, and she asks, why haven't you been traveling or gone on a holiday for so long? Is it because of the kids? Now, if you're new to my channel, you'll know that I did live overseas. I lived as an expat in Malaysia for nearly 5 years, 4.5 years. I'm currently in Canada, and I'm married to a pilot. And I feel like it's that trifecta of information, oh, and then the side factor, my kids are 3 and 6, that have kind of prevented us or reduced the desire to travel. Now, without getting too heavy into it, because you know I can chat, the first one is this, I married a pilot. It's likely being married to a masseuse. I doubt that a masseuse comes home and is like, hey baby, can I massage you? I've been massaging people all day. Do you know what I mean? The other thing is, it is extremely expensive to fly and travel in North America. Like, ridiculous. I mean, I remember going to Singapore for the equivalent of like $40. To go anywhere in Canada, it's like nearly $1,000 return, and each person in my family, even the 3-year-old, is the same price. I find that an exorbitant expenditure. So we've been doing like little camping trips in the summer and just like kind of simplifying our life a little bit. Now, I have traveled a lot, so I don't personally feel like I'm missing out. That said, it is the middle of winter in Canada and I could seriously use a little vacation. So we're actually talking right now if we should take a little holiday. And then the last factor is that, well, I guess it's two factors, is that yeah, my kids are, you know, 3 and 6, and they're not at an age where they're really gonna remember a lot of this travel, and I kind of feel like it's wasted. Now, some of you may disagree. Go ahead and leave me some comments. I would love to know your perspective. We traveled, I did so much with them. My kids have been to many countries. They don't particularly talk about it or remember it like I remember it, and it's not really that enjoyable to have like kids on your shoulders and like trekking through town. And so we do a lot of stuff locally. Like, we go out for lunch, we go out for dinner, we do little day trips here and there. Like, we try to take advantage of our surroundings and really like get into that. That's kind of the long story. The reality is, I would love to go on a trip. I am going on a trip by myself in May for work, and I'm really excited. So I feel like I'm gonna get my thrill. But the kids don't know what they're missing yet. Now, give it a few years. Like, my aunt just went on a trip with her kids, and her kids are 7 and 9, something like that. They had an amazing time because the kids were old enough to experience it. You're not lugging around strollers. So I can see in that phase of life us doing a lot more travel. That was a little long-winded, but I am Amanda Muse, and that's how it works. Now, this is a new addition to my collection. This is the Bare Minerals Complexion Rescue Tinted Hydrating Gel Cream. And I went with the color Vanilla 02. I am pretty fair and I like the consistency. I have been meaning to try this for a while, but just kind of forgot about it, to be honest. And I realized what I really wanted was a foundation that was very light, pretty much a tinted moisturizer. Then I remembered this. This does have an SPF of 30, which is kind of amazing. So where I skip on the SPF in my moisturizer, I pick up here. And it is very light. You can already tell from the application. I did one whole thing on my face and then I went over this T-zone area. I do have a little bit of hormonal breakouts happening. It doesn't cover it perfectly, but I'm okay with that. I just wanted a light layer that makes me look refreshed and that I have a little bit of a uniformity kind of going on. And this is working working for me, and I like that it's bare minerals and that it's a mineral makeup. Moyam Juma Life on Instagram asks, any more children? Now, I know I get this question a lot naturally, as I am a parenting creator and in the parenting space, and I'm a woman and all of that jazz. No, we do not have any plans to have any more children. I'm very, very happy with my two babies. Life seems very manageable at the moment. Do I get baby fever? Oh, hell yes. Like, sometimes it comes on so strong, I'm like, Dean, go lock yourself in a room because I cannot be trusted. If it happens, it happens, but it would be a surprise and it would be a pleasant surprise, but it's not something I'm seeking out right now. I mean, I just got rid of the baby chair, or not the baby chair, but the booster seat in our kitchen, and like all my chairs push in at the table. This is an exciting moment. So I have recently gone back to my old reliable. A favorite is the NARS Creamy Concealer, Radiant Creamy Concealer in Vanilla. It has a very nice consistency. I have used this before and used it in full. Tried a few others because I'm not married to any product, and I came back to it this time just because I know it's a cult classic. It's so good. And it covers up the blemishes that I need. It's not too heavy. I don't find that it sets into any of my fine lines. So I know that a lot of these products are higher end. In fact, I think like most of them are, but I prefer to spend a little bit more on higher end products when I can, because I know that they're going to last me in the long run. Now, once I apply my base and I have my concealer in place, I cannot help but set that makeup. Not that I get overly oily in the day, it's just kind of what I do. From Tarte, I have Smooth Operator, which is the Amazonian Clay Pressed Finishing Powder. I've used this quite a lot. It has the little brush on the inside. I've already hit pan, but it's a lovely product. I've had it for quite a while, so it lasts me a long time. And I just take the brush that comes with it and I just brush it along my T-zone basically, and anywhere maybe I had a little bit of concealer, and I just feel like it sets it really nicely and there's no shine. So when I do videos like this, I'm not overly shiny, and just, you know, helps hold the makeup for the rest of the day. Now, this next question comes from Facebook, and this is from Anna, and she says, I'm all about tips of surviving with a toddler and a newborn. Going back to old school Amanda for me, please. So of course I am not in that phase anymore of having a newborn, but I always found that it's just like, give yourself a ton of grace and just be patient with yourself and remind yourself that your toddler is still a toddler. Because I think sometimes we bring this new baby home and we expect our other child to just not be a baby anymore, but they still kind of are, and they need just as much attention. So your newbie, once you have like fed and changed and you've laid them down, I know all you want to do is take time for yourself, because girl, I feel you. But take that older child and just snuggle up on the sofa, read a book. If you have people in your life that can help you out, this is your chance to ask them to spend more time with your older child, do more fun things with them, just to build that relationship up and remind your older child that they are just as important. You can task them with things depending on how old they are. I used to get Esme to go get me diapers all the time, just to have her help me with something, or give the baby his susu, his soother. You know, there's all sorts of things, but if you'd like, I have tons of videos on this kind of stuff. I will link a few of them up here for you, in some older playlists that I've had, just because I'm not in that phase of life anymore. I don't make videos about it, but girl, they still exist. So you just gotta go back in the history archives fingers. A little bit. Oily fingers have left fingerprints, but this is a new product. This is the Hourglass Ambient Luminous Bronze Light. It's a lighting bronzer, and this is amazing. I am in love with this product. Now, it does come in two shades. I went with the lighter one. And I had seen a couple comments on Instagram about just like being a little bit nervous to try new things, or maybe being stuck in a certain year for a makeup style. And I try not to follow trends too heavily. Like, I pay attention to the trends, but I'm very aware of what looks good on my face and what the look is that I want to achieve, which is fresh, I haven't tried too hard, glowy, like just vibrant, you know? And so right now, glowy skin is in. And so what I do is I take a big fluffy brush and I just kind of do a number three. So I hit the top of my forehead, and what you're thinking of is where the sun would naturally hit your face. So top of the forehead, top of the cheeks, maybe a little bit on the nose, and maybe down the neck here, just to kind of warm up this area. I am very fair skinned, a little on the cool side. And so when I apply this, I think it'll translate through the camera here, but I feel like my skin looks very warm. There's a warmth to it. It is the middle of winter. I couldn't be any more pale. It costs a pretty penny, but I'm obsessed. So if you're looking to add it to your repertoire, head over to Sephora, try it, which is what I did. I tried it and then I couldn't stop thinking about it for a week and had to go back and buy it. So worth just going in, giving it a test run and seeing if you like it. Back to Instagram questions. Gentle Thrifty Mama says, are you going to put Jack in full-time JK? And then there was another question from Hulig Elena. She answered a question before, but it was about Jack saying, you know, how is daycare going? Any separation anxiety? And how am I feeling about it now? So I thought I could kind of merge those questions. So Jack is ready for JK. Technically, I'm a little freaked out. I got an email last week about it being time to register him, and I was like, what is happening? He's my baby. So right now Jack goes to daycare 2 days a week, and it's a home daycare with someone I'm very confident and I feel very secure with leaving my child with. So he's having a nice time. It started off kind of rough. There was definitely some separation anxiety, but it was mostly just at the beginning of the day. So he would kind of be upset and crying as I'm leaving. That has definitely lessened. There are still some tears and a little bit of a quivery lip, which breaks my heart a little bit, but it's good for him and it's good for me because I can work from home and get a lot done while he's at school. In terms of school next year, I'm not the biggest fan of JK. Can I just throw that out there? It's kind of obvious because I pulled Esme out of JK when she was supposed to start because she was 3.5. Like, what? I see the perspective of JK, I'm in Canada by the way, and in Ontario, where kids can go to school when they're 3, between the ages of 3 and 4. And then based on the month that you're born, like you have to turn 4 in that year, basically. So Esme is being a December baby, was like 3.5. Now Jack, he's born in March, he'll be 4 when school starts. I do not feel he's ready for 5 days a week. I work from home. I have a little bit of flexibility in the way that I can be there for him. I think it's amazing for families where you have both parents who are working full time and all of a sudden, all that money they've been spending on daycare, woof, gets to be put back in their bank. That's amazing. I don't have that lifestyle. So that's kind of like not on the table. And because of that, he hasn't been in daycare full time. So for a lot of kids, it's a quick transition. It's like, we're going to this school and now we're going to big kids school. Cool. Jack's like home daycare 2 days a week where there's a nap to like, full school. So it's a hard transition. So my plan so far is likely going to be keeping him 1 to 2 days with his daycare provider. It hasn't been ironed out yet. And then potentially 2 days at big kids school and then 1 day home. So 4 days total of school. We're gonna kind of up it and see what that's like. And I will say this, that kids have a tendency to surprise us at their resiliency, and he might love school. And if that's the case, well, I'm gonna revisit this whole thing. But school's a really long time and you only get to be little once, and I don't mind like having him kicking around the house. Even if I have to work that day and he's mostly just entertaining himself, I'm cool with that. My husband does work a ton and goes away a ton, but is often home a lot too. So we have a different lifestyle where we can accommodate a more flexible approach to school. It was kind of long-winded, but that's how I'm going with it. And I feel very confident with this decision because I did that with Esme. We skipped JK entirely. She went to a little preschool, loved it, and she's excelling, and she is in grade 1, and she's speaking French, and I mean, there was no impact. So if you're worried about it, I could do a dedicated video to this, even a live perhaps, to answer questions as we go, but you know your kid deep down, you know what's right, and you'll make the right decision. So go with your gut. Next is the Anastasia Brow Wiz. I haven't bought one of these in a while. I came back to it, I've been using a powder, but this is just solid gold. So I went with a soft brown. You have the pencil, and on the other side, you have a little spoolie to do your eyebrows. And my technique is always brush, like draw on just very light hand and then brush away any excess powder, and then you'll get the look that you're looking for. I always kind of lengthen a bit, fill in any of the gaps, never go too heavy handed because it looks weird, but just practice makes perfect. So this eyebrows, you know I have a thing for eyebrows. I feel like eyebrows frame the face and it just adds like dimension, so worth giving it a try. Now the next product is blush. This is a new one to my collection. I just brought it the other day. So this is Benefit and it's the Dandelion Blush. I really liked how delicately and nice and pink this color was. I've been looking for just a very light pink. I like it. It even says on the back it's a baby pink powder, which is exactly what I wanted because again the look I'm going for is fresh and bright and dewy and like you have a natural flush going on. So it might look a little washed out on camera, but in real life it's just like a very natural look. And I'm digging it.
But on Instagram, Robin Kavanaugh was asking, has Esme ever asked about makeup? And when do you think is an appropriate age to start wearing makeup? Her mom took her to MAC the day before her first day of grade 7, and she'll never forget it. So yes, Esme has makeup, kid makeup. Some of it, I guess, could be grown-up makeup. She has a little makeup bag in the bathroom, and she's allowed to play with it when she's at home. And sometimes I'll play and like do a winged liner on her or something, but it's just in-the-house makeup. She's allowed to wear a chapstick to leave the house, but because we don't make a big deal out of it, it's not a big deal. She hasn't really shown any interest in like she needs to wear it. We make a big point of telling her that, you know, you don't need makeup, it's just fun to wear. And both kids, surprisingly, when I do wear a heavier makeup, like a full coverage foundation, they're not keen on it. They're always like, oh, mom, you look like weird, like it's too perfect. They like imperfections, and honestly, that warms my heart. But the right age, I don't know. I don't want to like put my foot in my mouth and say that this is appropriate. I feel like maybe 13, 14, starting to play with stuff. I was in about 8th grade when I started wearing eyeliner. Kids do it anyway. I don't know. I'm pretty laid back with stuff. And when she does start, I will give her good advice. So there's a win. Current mascara, you guys have seen this in a video before. This is the Voluminous Lash Paradise from L'Oreal. It is a waterproof one. It's a nice and thick voluminous wand. I don't normally buy waterproof mascara, but I do like having one on hand, especially like today. It's very snowy and I thought I was going to be shoveling the driveway. I think I still will. And I didn't want to be shoveling the driveway, getting all hot, and then have my mascara melt on my face. So I like that about this one. And I do find that this mascara just goes on so nice. It's nice and thick and dark and just does what I want it to do, especially on days where I am not wearing any eyeshadow like today. So I like this one. And the last thing is lip gloss, and I received this Glow Minerals lip gloss. And this is in the color Blushing, and it's just a really nice, simple lip gloss, but I just love it. It's the right color, I'm wearing it right now. I don't know, it just suits my face. It has a very nice texture about it, and it just works. And I think I'll end this lovely Q&A with a final question from Documented Journey, and she says, does Jack ever want to put on makeup or fingernail polish? Her son loved it. Yes. He pretends with makeup, but doesn't really want makeup because it would freak him out. And he's worn nail polish. I think my mom or Dean did like zombie skeleton nail polish and he loved it. And he cried when it came off in the tub. So, you know what? Who cares? Boys, girls, I'm all about a little gender fluidity. Have fun with it. Nothing is really off. You know, there's no holds bar on anything. I think you just have to like live a little. And, you know, I feel like these days we're far more open-minded about what's acceptable for people, not just like boys and girls. And so I like staying open-minded. So thanks for the great questions, everybody. I hope you enjoyed this Q&A. I hope you enjoyed this little fresh makeup look and the products I've been using lately. And thanks for tuning in. So if you're new, please subscribe. Let me know how you enjoyed this video. Give it a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Comment below. I'll see you in the next video. Bye, guys.